Hello and welcome to this demonstration of how to use the FAA's new Controller Pilot Data Link Communication Services System. This system allows you to receive your clearances and to send and receive messages from the controller to your FMS. In this short video, we'll demonstrate the logon process, session establishment, clearance request, and CPDLC message processing. For purposes of the demonstration, we'll assume that the aircraft is powered up, IRUs are aligned, a flight plan has been filed for the aircraft tail number and flight ID, and the AOC has preloaded the aircraft with their filed flight plan. In order to communicate with the tower using DataCom, a connection must first be established. Pilot can log on to the tower at any time during the pre-flight process. A session will not be established until at least P-30 and after the controller has reviewed the filed flight plan and moved it to the prepared list. In normal operations, this is expected near P-30. In congested operations such as weather, runway changes, and large pushes, it can be P-20 or less. You can expect to see either log on and session established or just logged on. The session establishment will occur automatically after the controller completes their tasks and the time parameters are met. To log on, select ATC on the MCDU. Do not go to the flight information page. In the Log On To field, enter the tower ID for the clearance delivery tower you want to connect with. For example, enter KACY. Enter your entire flight number in the field indicated. For example, UAL9901. This must be identical to the entire flight number filed on the flight plan. If the numbers don't match exactly, a failure to establish the session will result. If the field is not already populated, enter your tail number. For example, November 69826. Like the flight number, this must match the filed flight plan exactly. Most connection failures result from an incorrectly entered flight number or tail number, usually a detail like omitting the N, transposing the numbers, or not including the company letters in the flight number. To initiate the log on, select Line Select Key 1 Right, which is the Send button. You should notice the word Accepted illuminate. After the controller has processed your flight plan and moved it to the prepared list, your display should read ATC.com/established in your scratch pad. Finally, verify ATC Center, which in our example should display KACY. Next, let's look at the clearance request procedure and how to request your departure clearance from the tower. To request your clearance, begin by selecting ATC Index. Line Select Key 6 Left. Select Clearance. Line Select Key 4 Right. Adding any free text to your request will cause the system to reject the request. Select Send. Line Select Key 5 Right. The status displays open, and an audio chime is activated upon receipt of a message. You should see ATC message in the scratch pad. Or on some models, this alert will display in the ICAS. Depending on the model, you may also notice the message light on the MCDU illuminates when a message is received. There are only two possibilities when receiving your initial clearance. Either you are cleared as filed, or the controller has changed your clearance. The first example we'll look at is the most common you should experience in the tower environment, the cleared as filed. You'll need to review the message that is received. Select Uplink, Line Select Key 1 Left. In this case, you received a Cleared as Filed message. Cleared as Filed messages should contain a SID or climb out instructions, altitudes, squawk, and radio frequencies. Use the Next Page button on the MCDU to view the entire message and verify the contents match your expectations. For a cleared as filed message with no altitude assigned, you'll notice there is no option to reject the message. If in the rare case you no longer intend to fly the route you filed, you'll have to revert to voice to make your request. Once a cleared as filed has been received, you'll be able to reject any future revisions. We'll look at revisions to accepted clearances a little later in this video. In order to accept the cleared as filed message, select Line Select Key 5 Right. Add your SID and transition. And select Execute on the MCDU. You'll want to clean up any discontinuities on the screens. You have just received and accepted your first Datacom clearance message. This simulation starts after log on. Request your clearance by selecting ATC Index. Select Clearance, Line Select Key 4 Right. Select Send, Line Select Key 5 Right. The status displays open. Wait for the audio chime or visual indication alerting you to the received message. If the controller cannot provide you with a cleared as filed, you'll receive a revised initial clearance. As with any clearance, you'll need to review it. Select Uplink, Line Select Key 1 Left to view the message received, and the Next Page button on the MCDU to view the entire message. You should receive a new route or new portion of the route you originally requested, as well as a SID or climb out instructions, altitudes, squawk, and radio frequencies. To review the message, load the message using Line Select Key 4 Right, and page through the clearance while observing the route specifics on the MCDU and nav display. After your review, if you determine that you're able to comply with the new clearance, select Send associated with Accept, Line Select Key 5 Right. If not, select Send associated with Reject, Line Select Key 5 Left. No reason code can be added to the rejection. If the clearance cannot be accepted, you must contact the controller on voice after sending the rejection. Add your SID and transition, and select Execute on the MCDU. You'll want to clean up any discontinuities on the screens. You have just processed your first Datacom revised initial clearance message. You can exchange clearances at the gate, in the movement area, or on taxiways to the hold short line. In this scenario, you have already received and accepted your clearance and are just pushing back from the gate when the controller has to change your clearance. You are alerted to a new ATC message by the chime and visually. Select ATC on the MCDU and read the revised clearance, taking note of what has changed. You may be receiving a whole new route, a portion of the route, a new SID, or even a non-route revision. Regardless of the type of revision sent, you'll need to review the new clearance in its entirety. However, the revision contains indications that will direct you to what has changed. To review the clearance content, select the Load prompt, Line Select Key 4 Right, and page through the clearance while observing the route specifics on the MCDU and nav display. If the route changed, you should notice a dotted white line, the new route, and a magenta line, your previously cleared route. Ensure that you can comply with the new route and all other requirements of the revision. If you determine that you are able to comply with the new clearance, select Send associated with Accept, Line Select Key 5 Right. If not, select Send associated with Reject, Line Select Key 5 Left. Add your SID and transition, and select Execute on the MCDU. You'll want to clean up any discontinuities on the screens. You have just processed your first Datacom revised clearance message. This video does not attempt to cover every detail of the new services being offered by the FAA, nor does it cover all of the issues that might prevent the system from delivering message traffic and require the crew to revert to voice communications. But we hope it provides a basic understanding of some new terminology and how to use these new services to reduce communication delays at busy airports. Thanks for watching.